I'm going to have a little morning walk in the fog. These are peonies that shot up the last 2 days in April. This flowering bush, these two, on the right and the left. Our external fragrance, I think Daphne bushes of some kind. Phlox grown behind the tulips. Coreopsis. And Scabiosa coming up. And the carpet phlox starting to bloom. I had cut this back tremendous amount last year. It's taking over the whole area. It's pretty hard to kill them. And this is in the shade. These come bloom later. And they are creeping and taking over too. The new garden area is ready for planting. Though I did do some cucumbers here, and a pepper plant, and zucchinis, and squash, and this one. All in Mel's Mix. This Mel's Mix. These beds are for tomatoes. That one needs to be dressed up with some more compost. I have to get rid of the lettuce because those are going to be tomatoes. I'll have 15 tomato plants here. These mums along the fence here, except these alliums. Really starting to come up now. Weather's warming up. Of course, I have to do some weeding. These are the Alaska peas. They're going to vine up about 2 feet. These are sugar snap peas. Sugar snap beans. Not peas. We can eat the pods, but they're going to climb up this terrace. I don't know if the fog is coming through, but it's so nice and foggy out, and there was a beautiful moonset this morning. My husband and I went out and checked out before the sun came up, before the light came out. No sun yet. It's lettuce. My greenhouse, the plants I'm hardening off. This is a butterfly bush I ordered, came in last fall. It looks like it's got some leaves coming up. I think they grow fast. We've got a dove up there. His mate is around somewhere. And they want my broccoli leaves. It's garlic, and we've got some, a row of lettuce, beets, carrots, spinach, borage, garage. Onions. I'm gonna put herbs in these cinder block holes. But this is gonna be a half moon garden where I've got my broccoli, Swiss chard under the row covers, bush beans over here, a little water feature, columbine, daylilies, this is where I feed the birds in the winter. I don't feed them in the summer, but they're safe under here from the cats in the neighborhood. Speaking of cats, here's this little guilty guy. This flower garden I put in last year because I had hardly any pollinators. It was one time in May I realized I didn't have any. So I dug up all the grass here and made a perennial flower garden. Nothing for summer's coming up. This area here is a little shadier than the center part of it. Some ferns coming up. I have some daisies and tall phlox, St. John's wort. Starting to come up by that yellow broken pot. Catmint and bee balm. I forget which is which. This is a big flowering bloomer. I forget what it's called. I feel like saying Daphne again. Begins with a D. Of course, the irises are phlox. Knockout roses. And here I have a clematis I have to move, put near a trellis somewhere. Of course, all my hostas are coming up. Let's go take a look behind us. Hostas, hostas, hostas. What is coming up and bloomed is the bleeding hearts. One at each corner of the deck. And these fences are protectors of the hose. Unless I throw it in the bush. Daylilies. Milkweed's gonna be here. My onion that I was growing in this planter fell over in the winter. And now look. Lots of onion grass. Half moon garden. And that's the tour on this foggy morning.